Human Rights Declaration. Human Rights Declaration is a document that has been signed by the members of the United Nations, which are signatories to this declaration that was made on December 10, 1948. It mentions a number of rights that humans enjoy and should therefore be respected by all signatory countries. There were additions made to this declaration that started its proceedings, its effective application on December 10, 1948. The signatories, that is, the countries that have signed this declaration, are bound by the stipulations of the declaration. That is, when the declaration demands that the citizens of all countries of the world, or those that agree with the Human Rights Declaration, they should enjoy all those rights that have been declared as the basic human rights of all humans. So the understanding is that all people who are living in the countries that are signatories to this declaration, the governments, the rulers, they undertake, they declare and promise that those rights are going to be provided to the citizens living in their respective countries. And if there are going to be any violations, then it is the rulers and the society that is going to be considered as criminals in the eyes of the universal law of human rights that has been declared. So it really is something that was a turning point in the history of mankind, in a sense that a large part of human population has come under one understanding of what is the bare minimum expectation that all humans can have and must enjoy while leading their lives in their respective countries. The implications of the declaration are that once the declaration has been signed by a country, it is promising that it will abide by the expectations of the declaration. Now, the declaration has got to do with humans, their rights, the values that must be respected, the morality that is the underlying spirit behind the declaration has to be acknowledged, has to be recognized. Once a country signs, and as I said, most countries, most Muslim countries as well, have signed this Human Rights Declaration, therefore they are bound to follow the expectations of the declaration. We have seen it time and again that the Quran mentions that Muslims are expected to abide by the promises that they make. If there is an undertaking that they have given, they must abide by it. Either don't promise, or if you have promised, then you must fulfill your promise. So it's absolutely obvious that all countries of the world, including all Muslim countries, including Pakistan, it has now become imperative that what they have agreed to and what they have signed as common understanding of basic human rights in the declaration is what they must make arrangements in their respective countries to make sure that those rights are not violated, and those rights are given to their population, their peoples, in letter and in spirit. So it really is something that is directly relevant to our discussion of morality and ethics, because on the one hand, Pakistan is a signatory to the declaration, and therefore that declaration has to be understood and followed. And number two, the declaration has got to do primarily with morality, with the rights of human beings that they must enjoy.